Good news, there's no waiting in the waiting room. My name's Grace Schroeder, I'm the CEO of a company called IDSU. We've come to market with a product that we're calling Slinger. Let me stop and ask, and I'm sure there'll be a lot of raised hands, how many of us use Slack? Perfect. So we build business applications, and we actually don't really do well at coding things. We're going to hold it. And when we've been for the last several years building business applications on our platform for primarily B2B, and because we have a platform, we can create custom software as a service very quickly. About a year ago, we started to use Slack, and we noticed that we were spending our entire day in Slack. And I don't know if you guys know the statistics, but people that use it typically spend about 10 hours a day. And we still use our own tool that we have to sort of track our to-do list and our punch list to complete our customer projects. But we got irritated because we chat in Slack, and then we had to scroll share into our own app, and we ended up just getting irritated. So we actually devoted a product to the interaction with Slack, such that Slack can be a dominant user interface for the product. And we're calling that product Slinger. And in order to use the keyboard, we're going to have to declare victory on this. So the application Slinger is a very simple software as a service that we use really kind of as a CRM. And the application as it stands today is pretty much at an early stage. And because we have a platform, we can continue to push features into the platform now that we're listed on the Slack App Store. We also have integrations that are sitting in this platform. And the first one we've added is the Google Contacts integration, and that lets us pull contacts out of Slack out of Google Contacts into Slack. So I'll just show you a little bit about how we work. So we organize our projects by channel. And each channel has a corresponding channel in Slinger. And because we have this application, we can organize the channels, whether they be opportunity channels, project channels, really any other type of channel we want. We can add a little bit of structure to Slack that doesn't sit in native Slack. So as we're chatting about a project, most times some sort of an action item would come. And we can use hashtag commands or slash commands to drive the activity in the backend application. So create a demo to show them their data, and I can assign it to whoever I want, or I can assign it to myself, and that creates a ticket. Well, it does if I don't know how to use this. I'm going to do this the old way. Mm-hmm. I'm used to the half tabs. It creates a ticket in the back end that's easy to navigate to. And now that we have this task, we also have all these other actions and all these other ways to workflow that particular ticket. Now that I've done this, many times when I just go create this task, out of the gate, I can easily close that task from here. I can reassign that task from here with a series of hashtag or Slinger commands. So if you look at the other types of things we talked about, which are fetching contacts, this is my favorite, Google, we can now fetch contacts out of Google Contacts and straight into Slinger. So the idea is that over time, as more and more functionality comes on, we're using Slinger really as our primary user interface to this backend application, and we're hopefully giving companies an alternative to traditional CRM and some of these heavier weight applications that tend to cost more time than they stay. So how many of us are highly technical in the room? One. So just to give you an example of the way that we're able to build this, we built Slinger with this backend tool, and this This is what lets us make modifications very quickly. So as we get users and they give us feedback, if they say to us, hey, we want an action for time tracking, we can add an action for time tracking. We can have that time tracking happen straight in Slinger because we have this backend tool that lets us go in here and add fields, you know, add those actions that you just saw. We can literally add things on the fly according to however the user base wants them. We also have, you know, a whole slew of additional endpoints that we'll be bringing to market with, you know, with corresponding functionality that can be done out of the stack. There you have it. Yeah.
What's your marketing strategy for getting the businesses for making this grow? And then what's your training strategy as well if you're looking at opening up new businesses that may not have adopted Slack but are interested in what you can do?
So we just listed on the Slack app store, I want to say 3 weeks ago. So that was our beachhead into our go-to-market for this. Our idea is that we will, we're marketing that, so we have a series of landing pages out there, testing the messaging, doing all the things that you will, and starting to get the sign-ups and understand what our cost acquisition model is. But our next iteration as a company is that we would get these out there in the hands of hopefully highly technical users, and then we will release this back-end developer tool so that developers can get in there and really make this bot do whatever they want. There is also an integration framework, so they'll be able to also create the other endpoints that they want, and we can sort of be that mothership of all the things that are orchestrated to make a Slack experience for the enterprise. Training, haven't do that either.
So, do you ever have concerns, like for instance, Twitter with your API, where eventually they come back with the API, and you build a product that's not something that you own based on the existing product, there's always that concern that things will change, or hypothetically, Slack just says, we don't want to use you anymore.
So,
what's your...
Oh, so the question is, are we concerned that someday Slack may deprecate the API and we'll be left out of the fold?
How do you mitigate that risk?
We don't have to be Slack. So our platform is integration agnostic. It had Slack not come up, we would have been doing the same sort of thing around Google.
Okay.
So if we'll just hop around. And in fact, some new version of Slack. Symphony is competing with Slack in the financial services space. You can easily do a Symphony integration for that marketplace too. Yep.
So this is a little bit outside the core business of the company. So how do you work within the company to kind of promote something like this, which is maybe not necessarily the most strategic investment?
It's not actually outside of the core business. So we have a platform team and we have a front end team. And our platform team are day in and day out, they're the ones managing this endeavor. Our front end team builds applications like Slinger for businesses. So this is sort of another in the portfolio, which is potentially has a bigger block of transactional clients. Ultimately, we'll staff for this separately. Ultimately, as we launch to the developer community, our front-end guys will go to support Spirit-guided developers through the back-end tool.
We have time for one more question.
Come on. Give me my minute.
Any other customers besides yourself? Yeah.
Pardon?
Any other customers?
Oh yes, we've been in production with customers for 3 years. This platform is a very big piece of work. I mean, it's well over a million lines of code, and it's been, last year we spent not growing direct customers, but grooming the API getting ready for the developer launch. So it's been in production for 3 years. With a handful of customers that we probably caused some pain as we completed the development. We like to hurt people, but they stay with us because we've been in a great solution. Thanks, appreciate it.